Now, ladies and gentlemen, moving on to the welcome address. To begin this evening, may I call on stage an entrepreneur, journalist, internet evangelist, and media expert all rolled into one. There he is. He's told me he's just out here to have fun. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the man himself, Dr. Anurag Batra, Chairman, Editor-in-Chief of Exchange for Media and PW Business World. Let's hear it out.
Thank you so much. It's my honor and privilege to be here. I remember Pitch CMO Summit used to be called Pitch Brainstorm. We started it. Pitch is our oldest print publication. We started Exchange for Media 17 plus years back, not to build a media company, but we wanted to build a marketplace, Karthik. We wanted to build a commerce one, or a rebirth for the media industry where buying and selling of media time would. Of course, we failed at that for various reasons. We were ahead of time. Media is a very face-to-face, relationship-based business. Technology assimilation was not good. You know, when you raise money and you're not able to do, you find reasons why. I'm very good at it. Right? I could go on to do better things, right, in life. Second, it's my first time after the new chief minister has been sworn in, and after I've got permanent head damage, I recently got a PhD. A lot of people ask me, what did you get the PhD for? I said two things. One is for emailing. Those who work with me know, you know, and I tell them it's not a bot called Batra that emails, it's me, right? Second is for eating edamame beans. The Japanese edamame beans, I eat them faster than anybody I know. So if it was an Olympic sport, Karthik, I would win a medal for India, but unfortunately it is not. But on a serious note, last time I was here on 1st November, first I want to acknowledge the presence of some of my friends who over the years have helped me grow Exchange for Media, learn a little bit about the media industry and also lose hair. Karthik, Mr. Karthik Sharma is the CEO of Wavemaker. He's our keynote speaker here. And he's a busy and a big guy. He has big responsibilities. Your being here, Karthik, adds to our event, and I look forward to your session. Please give Karthik a big round of applause. I know, Ranjit, you're not a sponsor today, but it's okay. You're a friend. Ranjit Kate of Vijay Karnataka. Ranjit has been a friend. He was in Bombay. He moved there. I try and have lunch with him whenever I'm Arvind, I'm not able to make two Hat Club Bangalore events. I'll be a little more free, so you can call me this year. I'll try. Thank you, Arvind, for being here. I also want to take this opportunity. You know, it is customary to thank your team at the end. You know, Sneha, I think most of you know Sneha Walke. It is Sneha's event. I'm a guest. I spend all my time in business world. There's lots of work to be done there. Exchange for Media is doing okay, is doing well. Business world is also doing well, but needs to do better. So, Sneha, I want to thank you. Continuity in business and life matters. It means learning, it means scale up. And Sneha has been with us. This is our 8th year. She's among the few colleagues of mine who joined us 8 years back, and her hair is still black. There are some whose hairs have turned white, like Noor Fatima Wansia, because she has spent 15 years with me. But she's, so Sneha's event, and you know, Sneha is extremely driven, and this is her event. Jyotsna, you know, Pitch, we started on 15th October 2003. I remember, I have to tell you this story, Karthik. You know Jeffrey Krasto? So we started, we did the launch at the Gallups, and we did a launch, and we didn't used to have that much money, not that we have too much now. We're in Bangalore, with $15 billion being raised and all. So we have very little money as compared to that. But we had much later money then. So we did the launch at Gallups, and we launched Pitch. A lot of people got drunk. So Jeffrey Krasto came to me and Naval and said, what is Pitch? It's a cricket magazine. Why are you guys launching a cricket magazine? So we launched Pitch on 2003, 15th October, I remember. And then it's done well, but we were looking for a new editor. I met about 20 people in 1.5 years. And I sometimes hire in 3 seconds. I just ask them their sun sign. You know which sun sign I hire first. Most people know in my office, right? And I hired Jyotsna. I got her to do visualizing. She used to edit an art magazine. And I can tell you that Jyotsna has transformed Pitch. And it's on its way to being hugely transformed. She's done lots of good work. So Pitch is, again, it has vigor, rigor, And, you know, she's trying to build something special for us. So, Jyotsna, thank you for being such a leader of Pitch. And right now in Exchange for Media, all our editors except one, Abhishek, who runs our Hindi platform, Samachar for Media, which is like Exchange for Media in Hindi, because in Hindi journalism, we want to change that, the quality of Hindi journalism. We started that. Our editor of Exchange for Media is Nazia. The editor of Impact is Shrabna. Editor of Pitch is Jyotsna. The editor of our real estate magazine is Sapna. I think, I don't know why we do that, but it happens. Last but not least, I want to talk about the theme of the conference here. We cannot talk of marketing if you don't talk of technology. But I want to say three of my favorite themes, and I want to caution on three things. I normally don't use PowerPoint presentation, and I'm following that today. You know, Karthik, why I don't use PowerPoint presentation? I believe PowerPoint presentations are used by people who are neither powerful nor have a point of view. I'm Arnab's friend, right? We saw a public there, right? But let me talk to you about the two themes that I really believe in and I practice. I believe marketing must be learned from people like Karthik, from people who are creating new brands, Rashmi, new businesses. But I believe that marketing should also be learned from people who are not from marketing business. I believe you can learn more marketing from Narendra Modi. I'm not saying he's not, I mean, it's not just marketing. You have to market the country. You have to market. You can learn it from politicians. You can learn it from authors. If you write a book that sells 3 million copies, you know what audiences want. And you marketed it well. You can learn from sports people. You can learn it from movie professionals, from entertainers, from comedians. Because marketing is about connecting with people. It's about understanding audiences. It's about storytelling. Second, how many CMOs in the room? How many CMOs? Or marketing heads, okay. 10, 12, okay. How many CEOs in the room? Like 10, 12, car. You know, I keep saying that most CMOs aspire to be CEOs. But how many CEOs are actually CMOs? And I want to give you this example, because I know this firsthand. There's a bank called the Yes Bank. It was started about 15 years back. I have multiple relationships with them at different levels. They're invested in Business World. Mr. Kapoor, in his personal capacity, he's the same sunshine as you and me, number 9 Virgo. Right? I can tell you, he met a friend of mine called Ramesh Jude Thomas, who's from Bangalore, about 15 years back, and he said, oh, I'm going to call my bank Yes Bank. So he asked Ramesh, what do you think? Ramesh said, Ramesh obviously wanted to make a fee from him. He said, not a good name. I'll come back with a good name. Pay me a lot of money. Mr. Kapoor is very smart. He's built a $10 billion, $11 billion. And he named it Yes Bank. And I can tell you, he's the brand manager or the CMO of Yes Bank. I know there is a Rajat Mehta, there is an Amit Shah, but for retail and for B2B. But I can tell you that most CEOs should be brand owners. And, you know, I will take the name, I believe in abundance. We should do well, our competition do well. There's enough for everyone. There used to be a magazine when I was younger called A&M. I used to read that. I used to store copies. I still have old copies. I store magazines, I'm that kind of person. Store newspapers. And, you know, magazines and newspapers will be around for a long time. We in the print business don't do a good job of talking about ourselves. There's more credibility to newspapers, magazines, than there is to anything. Right? And that I'm not. But I'm sharing this because really marketing is a lot about observation. It is a lot about storytelling. Technology is a help. I also want to sound out three, and Mr. Rana Kapoor went ahead and named it Yes Bank, and of course he's built a fantastic brand. Banking is a lot about trust. And he's built that trust. Today, I'm sure when you talk about the economics of CX, you'll talk of technology, you'll talk of programmatic, you'll talk of storytelling. But two very worrying things have happened in the last 30 days. Donald Trump's birthday is 14 June. Something more worrying happened on 11 June. What was that? What happened on 11 June? in the world. That has an impact on my life, your life, your life as a consumer, your life as a marketer, as a media owner, as an agency, as a brand owner. What happened on 11th June? That's right. So the net neutrality was struck down. Last night I checked in the hotel at about 3 a.m. and I was watching the Kimmel show, and he had a good spoof saying Netflix has just launched a new show called Buffering. Right? But on a serious note, net neutrality means, you know, we are in a city where small businesses that started 5, 7, 3 years back are billion-dollar businesses. Small and mid-sized businesses could dream to be big. Net neutrality makes sure that consumers don't get the right deal, that small businesses, mid-sized businesses don't get the advantage. And I'm not going to talk about video content, but generally net neutrality is a very bad thing. It has tremendous implications for our ecosystem. Second, we are living in a super connected world. We all are connected. One danger that we are not talking, and we are citizens, we are people from the news domain there, you know, people who run newspapers, is cyber warfare. Today, our economy can be shut down by a single, you know, electronic intervention, if I may use that term. And every country in the world has a cyber army. Today, apart from physical arms, most, you know, Israel is a country that is supplying technology to every country in the world. Except maybe one or two countries, they may not be able to supply technology. So we are not talking of how, you know, in media in India, we're not talking of course, we have a very proactive government, very, very proactive national security advisor, a lady as a defense minister, and I'm sure they won't be able to talk about those things. But I think I genuinely believe that we as a nation are not thinking enough about cyber warfare. My last worry. I was reading this cover story in Bloomberg. I read other magazines, you know. Life is about coexistence. It was on ad frauds in digital. You know, we talk of programmatic, and we say, oh, newspapers don't make them. Newspapers possibly deliver better quality of advertising than anything else. Since you didn't sponsor, I'm still kind of your plug. Right? I genuinely believe that. I still read newspapers. Some days I'm in a hurry, I miss them. So ad today, the biggest thing is ad frauds on technology. It's a big issue. I'm sure, Karthik, you can address that. So I just don't want to kind of be a cheerleader for what we do. I also believe it's right now there is a fight for the soul of this nation happening. And I'm not a political person, but I feel uncomfortable for certain things. If media agency CEOs who put clients' money, put pressure on content owners in news media, in newspaper, to get their content, TRP should not be the only barometer for putting money, whichever channel. It should be how responsible they are. You know, you know, there's a certain friend of mine, I won't take his name. Satya knows who I'm talking. He's a very close friend of mine, and I help him. I don't agree with the kind of content he does. He's a nice guy, but do nice guys divide the nation on Muslim, Hindu, right? And I don't like this Bharat Mata Ki Jai business. You do real work, raising slogans. So I think brand owners who put money into media and, you know, advisors, consultants, gatekeepers, investors, whatever you want, you can really, there should be a content matrix to put money. How responsible? I think it's very, very important. If the INB minister listened to my advice, I'd say no TRPs. Of course, marketers need a measuring system, so some formula has to be there. So I just want to end by saying that I hope, apart from whatever we do in terms of creating wealth by doing revenues, by building brands, we think of not just selfish wealth, which I call sampati, we think of shared wealth, which I call sampada. So we have to, and people in the media are in a big position to influence that. Since I'm here on Business World time, I want to tell you that since the time we built Business World, whatever I'm talking, I'm trying to do that. So we have a thicker, more vibrant business world than we've ever had. We built a digital business which is about 10 million UVs every month. We built communities like Exchange for Media in 11 industry domains, and we have events. We have the marketing white book coming up. It's in Bombay on 20th July in St. Regis and 27th July in Delhi. We'll soon announce a date in Bangalore. which will be first week of Bangalore. And I just want to say that leaders who have not spoken at any conferences are speaking there. For example, Deepak Iyer of Mondelez, since he joined Mondelez, he's never spoken at a conference. I also want to say that my first theme of learning from non-marketeers, you will see that being implemented. For example, on 31st July, we have a BW dialogue. We believe leadership should be learned from people beyond, again, just corporate CEOs. So we have Shane Watson talking to an audience of 300 people on leadership, on winning, on competitiveness. So I hope you log on to businessworld.in every day. My shareholders would like that. I'm doing this on Businessworld time. I look forward to learning something about advertising, marketing, media, because I genuinely believe the more I learn, the less I know. This is the UB40 song called Higher Ground. I think there should be a session about learning from non-marketeers. Next time we'll put that. Thank you. Bangalore is my favorite city. I came for one day. I'm already thinking of staying till Sunday. So I'm putting my money where my mouth is. And Nagesh Rama Rao has joined us in Bangalore. He's the head of sound for Businessworld. We finally got a good guy. And I hope we're able to create something special with all of you. Thank you for being a good audience, and God bless you.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Batra. That was truly inspiring.